So in today's video, we're going to be talking about Hiei's moveset in Jump Force Season 2 DLC. And we're doing this because Hiei is a topic of discussion in the Jump Force community. A lot of people seem to think that this character is going to be a DLC Season 2 character for Jump Force DLC. Well, I decided to go ahead and try to think of Hiei's moveset in Jump Force Season 2 DLC. So this is going to be me, and I really had to scrape to find a moveset besides Dragon of the Darkness Flame, because everyone, that's probably like 99% of the reason people want this character. They want Hiei for the Dragon of the Darkness Flame technique. That's just the way it is. But before we get into all that discussion, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, click that notification bell, enable all notifications for the number one Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 Fighters anime gaming and Jump Force channel on YouTube and the internet. Of course, the quality is in the name itself, perfection. And let's jump right into it. Okay, so again, like I said in the beginning of the video, we were talking about the Dragon of the Darkness Flame. And I wanted to go ahead and get the obvious out of the way first so we could get down to the nitty gritty later. So the Dragon of the Darkness Flame is without a shadow of a doubt going to be his ultimate technique, because I do not see it working as anything else but. And I really hate it because projectile ultimates tend to suck in Jump Force. You have to be really specific with how you go about landing them. Like, Goku gets lucky because Spirit Bomb can land from grab, but if you try to hit it any other way, it won't work. Kaguya's is pretty much in the same boat, because you have to hit it from a super technique, and that's it. So unless you have a grab or a super attack combo that you can use, projectile ultimates tend to be pretty much useless. Unless it works like Shoto Todoroki's current ultimate, or I would, and it's gonna be a little OP, but unless it could hit through grab or has really great tracking to catch people mid-movement, it's inevitably going to be a beautiful ultimate to look at, but it's going to be borderline useless. And that's really what I think. Unless he has some kind of grab that's going to be easy for ult grab combos, I just don't see this ultimate technique being worth anything until later on. So the next thing that we're going to be talking about, we're going to get into his super techniques. Now, I really had to scrape for these, because technically in Yu Yu Hakusho he only displays one regular technique, that technique being the Fist of the Immortal Flame. Now, Fist of the Immortal Flame was made so that he wouldn't have to keep on spamming Dragon of the Darkness Flame, because at that point in the Dark Tournament, he couldn't really spam that technique over and over again without doing significant damage to parts of his body. He almost lost an arm to it because the dragon damages the user until he is able to be tamed. So he came up with the Mortal Flame technique, and sadly, the more and more I look at Hiei, he's just becoming a Sasuke 0.5. I mean, the Mortal Flame technique basically works out to be a Fire Chidori. Like, it's really one of those techniques. It's just basically Fire Chidori. And that's it. Like, there's no more explanation for it. Like, besides this, now you're gonna get really into the digging that I had to do. So his second move could be Dragon Absorption. Now, I can imagine this being like a general stat up technique where he absorbs energy from the Darkness Flame. And basically, I just don't know what I would want to do with this technique. I mean, the creative side of me wants to make it aware every time he uses this technique, it would make the actual ultimate stronger. So you're powering up the Dragon of the Darkness Flame technique to where it would be a one-hit guaranteed KO. So if you use this like two or three times, Dragon of the Darkness Flame is going to wipe out the opponent regardless of what health they have. Yeah, like, that's the creative side of me. Now, if you wanted to be generic, you could just sit there and have it be a general attack and defense buff. I mean, why not have both? Why not make it to where if you use this technique three times, which would be the max, it would make Dragon of the Darkness Flame a one-hit KO. Guaranteed from anywhere. What if the opponent is 100% health? You're wiping out 100% of his health bar. And I feel like if the opponent just lets you sit up there and do this technique three times and then hit the ult, I feel like the one hit KO would be justified. Like, that's just me. And just make it a point to where maybe they do a social media, you know, press release or scan or whatever about it, and make the information known to the community so people can see it coming. But that's just me. So those have been two super attacks: Mortal Flame, Dragon Absorption, his ultimate being the actual dragon itself. And I really don't know what would be the third regular move, but I have thought of an awakening move. So just to make Hiei a little bit more spiced up, since he doesn't have any, you know, ridiculous ultimates like transformations or whatever. I don't think we're going to be talking about the Jigan Eye State, since that's like really early on in Yu Yu Hakusho, and it's pretty much never used again after that, so it becomes completely irrelevant. I think we have to talk about him being pretty similar to Ichigo, and the fact that after he uses his awakening, maybe you could transform Mortal Flame into Dragon of the Darkness Flame, where he could use it regularly and just throw it out haphazardly. But okay, here's the drawback. I know a lot of people are about to get pissed off, but it loses that one hit KO synergy with Dragon Absorption. So that's the takeaway. So after he awakens, he can use the Dragon of the Darkness Flame technique whenever he wanted through the Mortal Flame technique. You know, maybe the Mortal Flame transform into Dragon of the Darkness Flame, but it just wouldn't, you know, be a one hit KO any longer. So that's how I would balance that out. Other than that, I don't really see anything else that you can make a moveset out of for Hiei. I really, really had to dig. And ironically enough, I just got through watching Yu Yu Hakusho all the way up through the Dark Tournament arc, and I'm about to finish it on up. Rewatching it, rather. But let me know what you think in the comment section below. That's the digging that I've done, and this is what makes me think that this character is the least likely to be the DLC candidate for Yu Yu Hakusho. Because, I mean, no, like, ridiculous awakening status like Yusuke, because at least Yusuke transforms into his, like, demon form. But, like, it's... Then you got the Sasuke 0.5 status. Like, I like Hiei. Don't get me wrong, I'm a Hiei fan. But I'm not about to sit here and pretend like he's just not like another like watered down Sasuke. I mean, the man literally has a Amaterasu dragon. But let me know what you think in the comment section below. Of course, I mean, your perfect being the number one anime gaming Dragon Ball Xenoverse and Jump Force channel on YouTube and the internet. Of course, the quality's in the name itself, perfection. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.